Welcome to another Amp Dyno video. This time I got a proaudio amplifier on the bench, and this is a JBL MPA 1100, which was made in 1993. So we have an old school amplifier on the bench. The amp is rated at 1100 watts into a 4 ohm load. This time I'm testing in bridged mono mode. That means you have to locate the switch on the back plate and set it to bridge. Connect your input signal to channel 1. Get back to the front, adjust the gain of channel 2 to maximum, and then you can adjust your gain with the left knob, channel 1 knob, to your needs. If you open up the cover, you see the mainboard, but this is only one channel. I replaced all rail capacitors. They were, if I remember correct, 15,000 microfarads with 63 volts, I guess. And I also replaced the output relays on the speaker board. And now we can start the dyno.
The dummy load is connected to the amplifier. In this case, I test bridged mono 16 ohms. That means I test for output power into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. The output power has to be divided by 2, and that's the output power into 8 ohms per channel, both channels driven. Continuous power test, 1 kHz.
That's the most I can get out of the amplifier. If I put some more signal in, it will not get into clipping. There seems to be a limiter inside the amplifier. And I check the output voltage. It's pretty high. We have over 200 volts at the outputs. I calculate with 225.6 volts.
I calculated an output power of 1630 watts. That means I get 815 watts into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. We have a little bit of clipping indication, so I will reduce until I don't have clipping indication, and then we recalculate the output power again. That looks clean enough. I take the lower value, 224 volts. In this case, I got 1608 watts, bridged mono 16 ohms, and that's around 804 watts into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Continuous power test with 50 Hz input signal. And we have a peak voltage of 224 volts. We got the same output power out of the amplifier with 50 Hz. The amplifier delivers also 804 watts into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Now I drive a 50 Hz burst with 100 milliseconds into the amplifier just to demonstrate a bass drum or something like this. And I try to get the last cycle. And we have a clip-free signal. And a peak voltage of 230.4 volts. Bridge mono 16 ohms, the amplifier delivers around 1700 watts with a 50 Hz burst signal of a duration of 100 milliseconds. That's 850 watts into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Now I'm testing this 50 Hz input signal, burst 200 milliseconds, 10 cycles. No signs of clipping in my cycles. I'm at 224 volts. Like continuous power. Same output power with 200 milliseconds, around 800 watts into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Now I'm testing for dynamic power, burst with 1 kHz, 20 cycles, and a continuous signal between the bursts, with a reduction of 20 dB. I have no clipping at the amplifier. Amplifier's clip LEDs are slightly illuminating. That looks okay. I reduce because I have light signs of clipping at the negative waveform. Let's take this, and I got a peak voltage of 259.2 volts. All cycles at the same voltage level, that's the goal I want to reach. That means the amplifier delivers 1076 watts into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Now I'm testing with a 8 millisecond burst test, 1 kHz. Now I try to catch the cycles. Increasing the signal, no clipping, slightly clipped. I reduce. Yeah, that looks clean. I can squeeze out a little more, but I take this. And I got a peak voltage of 252.8 volts. The amplifier delivers around 2048 watts. Bridged mono 16 ohms, that means the amplifier delivers around 1024 watts into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Now I'm disconnecting my four resistors because I want to switch to an 8 ohm bridged mono load. That means I test output power into 4 ohms per channel, both channels driven. Dynamic power test, 1 kHz, 20 cycles. This is my burst, reduced by 20 dB. And it's clip free, it says 227 volts. Try to get some more. Slightly clipped on the negative waveform. I go a little bit back, but I think that looks okay. 230.4 volts. Bridged mono 8 ohms. The amplifier delivers around 3400 watts. 1700 watts into a form load per channel, both channels driven to full power with a dynamic input signal, 1 kHz, 8 millisecond burst test. I go to the last cycle to check if there's clipping. I go higher. And I got peak voltage of 227.2 volts. Bridged mono 8 ohms, I got around 3310 watts. And that means I got an output power of 1655 watts per channel into a 4 ohm load, both channels driven. Continuous power test with 1 kHz. No clipping. Yes, we have 192 volts. I got an output power, bridged mono 8 ohms of 2333 watts. That's 1166 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Continuous power test with a 50 Hz input signal. Clipping. I got a peak voltage of 188.8 volts, 2256 watts. That means the amplifier delivers 1128 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power with 50 Hz input signal. Now I'm testing with a 50 Hz burst, that means 5 cycles, 100 milliseconds. I observe the last cycle, and we have a peak voltage of around 200 volts. Bridged mono 8 ohms, the amplifier delivers 2532 watts, 1266 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven with a 50 Hz burst signal. I test the 50 Hz burst with 200 milliseconds. I have a peak voltage of 192 volts. The amplifier delivers 1166 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven, if I use a 50 Hz input signal with 200 milliseconds, that means 10 cycles. I'm doing a 2 ohms per channel test, and let's have a look if the amplifier likes 2 ohm loads. I don't know, it said 4 ohms minimum per channel. Let's have a look. it's limiting. I go back, now it goes high again. No chance at all. The protection circuit is coming in and is limiting the output power if I drive a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven.
Thank you very much for watching this video. If you want to support my channel, just subscribe or leave a thumb up or hit the bell button to get information about one of the next videos I'm publishing in the future. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.